in Karam's book, Trial by Ambush, the blood on Robin's hands becomes ingrained into the pores of the skin, as though it had been heavily stained, then rinsed, but not scrubbed thoroughly. The blood on Robin could be explained in many ways. Some of it would have been blood spatter resulting from the bullet entering the wound site. Robin could simply have unconsciously reached up to his wound with his left hand after he was shot, and he could also have touched the bloody patches on his clothing. And if David is innocent, Robin must have changed his clothes in between the shootings of his family and taking his own life. The defense thinking around this is that Robin did not want to meet his maker wearing the clothes stained with the blood of his children and his wife. If that was Robin's intention, it seems strange he was content to enter the next life without thoroughly washing any vestige of their blood from his hands. If he was wearing the gloves and they became soaked with blood, it was also odd that no blood was found on the Seiko watch he was wearing. An officer who saw Robin's hands said they were dirty around his fingernails and the creases of his hands, and did not look like they had been recently washed. Swabs from his hands showed mainly dirt, so he probably didn't wash his hands at any time on the morning of the shootings. If he had wiped his hands, what did he wipe them on? No bloodied cloth was found. A handkerchief in his pocket had no bloodstains on it. Scrapings from underneath Robin's fingernails contained a substance that looked like blood, but the amount was regarded as inadequate for testing. The scrapings were sampled, but the samples were destroyed by police before more modern DNA testing was available. This was a bad mistake by the police, because it opened up another opportunity for doubt and speculation.